people like reconnecting on different projects.
Yeah, we tell that.
So tell me a little bit about your character you play in this movie.
So I play a store clerk who is not, he's the one who kind of finds out, I don't want to give away too much, but he's the one character that does not believe the main character. So he is kind of a pivotal role in the movie as far as things start to turn for my character. And it's also kind of the one, I feel like, comedic scene in the entire movie. I'm not trying to float my own boat, but it was like the one scene where, where like people, I think, get to laugh a little bit. So they gave me some comedy, which was fun. So yeah.
What was the highlight for you from working on this movie?
The highlight, I guess, probably walking into a random store that these guys let us use and just sitting behind a cash register and being able to do what I wanted and pretend I was the owner of the store or the guy who worked there. And I got to eat a pickle over and over again, and normally that would just seem kind of disgusting after a while, but it was actually a nice, you know, Brad Pitt has his whole thing. There's like this rumor that he eats every single time he acts, is what makes him seem natural. I think the pickle saved my life in this scene, because I was eating a pickle, it was very natural, so it kind of, yeah. So they actually called my character Thaddeus Dill. Yeah.
For the pickle part,
and it took me a very, sorry, I just spit all over. It took me a very long time to realize that was, oh, I get it, Dill. But yeah, that was fun. I got to play a douchebag, and I think I'm good at playing douchebags. Yeah.
Now, because Arena Cinema Lounge is all things independent movies,
yeah.
What were some of the highlights and also some of the struggles that you faced during the making of this movie?
You know, this movie, basically, we went to Oakland to do my scene, and some of the struggles, I mean, we made it work. It wasn't that tough. I mean, I feel like it was just fun. I got to be kind of a douchey guy, and in the last film I did with Ryan, I was a very straight, but it was a very kind of, you know, the straight man, you know, and I always like roles where I can get to be a little more character and just, you know, let go and not care. So there weren't any struggles. Yeah, for them there was.
Yeah.
But for me it was just a lot.
That's
yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And what do you hope people take away from watching this movie?
I think it's, you know, Doug did a really good job of creating a story that it's not what you think, you know. He really takes the audience for a ride. You think it's going one way, it's going another way. So I hope people will take from it, when people go through a certain level of depression, or try to cover who they are, or don't, you know, or aren't who they seem to be, there's more than meets the eye about a human being, you know what I mean? And so I think that journey that you take in the movie, I think we're all, again, I don't want to give away too much, but we're all hiding something. We all have masks on, don't we? And I think that they did an excellent job of capturing that. So I think a good takeaway was that, you know, when you meet somebody, you can judge them, and you might be right, but you should also take into consideration that we all have a dark path. We also have dark loves. And so I think the vulnerability is a fantastic one.
Thank you so much for talking to us. Thank you. Yes. Yeah, that'd be great.
And I saw your Gerard Butler thing. That was awesome.